Sterling, doing nothing. Your take on the BOE?
Pretty neutral. I think it's for investors, you can't separate the BOE from Brexit, obviously. And I think there was some hope that maybe because of the progress they made on the divorce bill, the BOE might be a little bit more hawkish. They did mention it in the statement, but really it wasn't very strong. And I think the base case of very slow and gradual hikes remains in place. We actually don't expect the next hike till the end of 2018, so not much to get excited if you're a sterling bull here.
Well, Vassili, let's talk about some things that are pretty exciting today in the central bank world, because we talk about the Bank of England, we talk about the ECB, we talked a lot about the Fed yesterday, but we got a lot of rate decisions today from Norway, from the Swiss National Bank, overnight from China. Norway in particular actually surprising markets and saying that they were going to possibly hike rates sooner than expected, possibly before the end of next year. The krona certainly responded. What's your take on this? Are we seeing a sort of global synchronized tightening that people were worried about?
Yeah, I don't know if it's synchronized, but there's a huge difference from 2017, right? We came into this year thinking, well, the Fed's going to hike, everything else is kind of a snoozer. Well, 2018 is going to be a year where different central banks are going to move at their own pace towards tighter monetary policy settings. So I think you have to pick your winners and losers here. I certainly think, from our perspective, the central banks in Scandinavia, for example, are probably underpriced in terms of how much more hawkish they can get.
Hold on a second. So you think that the krona's going to gain more?
Yeah,
we're bullish
on the region and Swedish currencies as well going into 2018, because this is the kind of an overlooked kind of part of European growth story, right? So these are the currencies that have their own central banks, so they're not tied to the dovish ECB outlook.